At 1 p.m. on the 25th of January 2019, a tailings dam at the Carrega de Feijão iron ore mine collapsed.
Primeiro veio devagarzinho como se fosse uma chuva. Ah, parece que o mundo estava acabando. Muitas pessoas falou.
The catastrophe destroyed a large amount of the complex owned by Vale. The dense and toxic mud from the ruptured dam hit the mine's administrative area and canteen, where hundreds of the mine's employees were having lunch. Farmland, livestock, railways and bridges were destroyed in seconds by a sudden release of mining waste. One day after, it was announced that 9 people had died, with 300 still missing. The governor of Minas Gerais addressed the nation, explaining the likelihood of anyone being rescued alive was minimal. Families of those missing had no choice but to await news from the authorities.
Onde são os nossos parentes? Cadê meu pai? Cadê meu pai?
According to Vale representatives, the cause of the accident was unknown, that the facility had not been in operation for 3 years and had been inspected regularly.
Os principais atingidos foram funcionários da própria Vale. Infelizmente, nós estamos falando que os funcionários da Vale tiveram seu restaurante soterrado e isso aconteceu na hora do almoço.
Sorte que era para ele estar dentro do restaurante, do refeitório, ele porque está de férias. Então, assim, Deus foi muito misericordioso com a minha vida, que ele poupou a minha família. A minha família foi restaurada, mas os meus amigos não.
Isso foi uma enorme tragédia, nos pegou totalmente de surpresa. Eu estou completamente dilacerado com o que aconteceu.
The head of the material which is escaping from the dam is advancing at about 100 miles an hour. This is a considerable force which not only destroys anything which is in its path, but also causes erosion. It scrapes up any pollutants which are in the river valley below the dam and spreads it further on down the valley.
By 3:30 p.m., the toxic mud had reached the Parapia River, the region's main water source. It also devastated Vila Viteco, a small community near the mine. The failure of the dam released about 12 million cubic meters of mining waste, enough to fill 480 Olympic-sized swimming pools.
So when these things flow downhill, there are many consequences. The first, obviously, is contamination. But there is another one that is probably worse, which is the destruction of agricultural land, destruction of forest. There will be quite some time for the community to recover and come back to, okay, now I can still grow my crops, I can still go back to my original activities.
The environmental impact of the collapse is still being evaluated, with authorities concerned the mud may eventually contaminate the São Francisco River, the second largest in Brazil.
The effects of such a dam collapse has a widespread effect on the economy. If it affects the fields which are close to rivers, or if there is irrigation along that river valley, then the fields become difficult to use. People don't buy vegetables which have been produced in fields near a river which is polluted.
Então usa o rio Paraopeba como alimento, porque é pesca, é para canalizar água para aguar a horta. Então hoje agora já não pode mais fazer isso. Então muitas pessoas estão prejudicadas devido esse rompimento da barragem.
Fishing tends to be wiped out for a number of years. It's a long-term process for restocking of fish after they've been wiped out by the lack of oxygen.
Brazil's National Water Agency carried out tests in the tributaries of the Parapia River and found concerning levels of magnesium, iron, and aluminium in over 200 kilometers of the river.
Dams like that, they do not just collapse. they normally collapse because there are a series of problems.
There's no infrastructure which lasts forever. We have to maintain the tailing dam.
Tailings dams are built to store mining waste in a valley. A dam wall, or dike, is built using the heavier, more solid waste. Tailings are then stored behind this wall. When the dam is full, a new dike is built. However, it's constructed upstream, with the tailings forming the majority of the base. This process continues over and over.
The problems related to the dam is that if you are not careful when you're depositing materials, you can start reducing the strength of the dam by contaminating some layers of the material with the slimes, and then all of a sudden, something that you did 2 or 3 years before will only be visible when you're sort of extending the dike, for example, and all of a sudden you have a collapse and you cannot explain because it is due to something that happened 1, 2, maybe 3 years ago.
Drainage is very important because when we make the design of a tailing dam, we take into account the lateral pressures of the tailings, which are solid materials. If we don't consider water, it means that we are neglecting the lateral pressure of the water, then what happens is that the tailing dam is subject to pressure which wasn't in the design and might produce the fail.
Brumadinho was not in operation since 2014. So we don't know yet, and this is the problem, we don't know how the collapse was triggered. It was not in operation, it was draining slowly, but it was still draining. Yes, there are rains and things like that, but the dam was still draining, so we don't know exactly why there was a collapse.
Vibrations from a work party installing a meter to measure the humidity of the dam. It is possible that the installation of this meter and the vibrations from the machine may have triggered the collapse.
There were some indications that Vale got a license to start remining the dam number one in that particular mine, Córrego do Feijão, and they were starting the processes. Whether that was the trigger or not, we don't know yet.
Nearly 1 month later, rescue workers were still finding bodies buried in the mud. Brazilian federal police have proposed criminal charges against Vale and Tuvzud, the consultants responsible for inspecting the dams, as well as 13 of their employees. So far, no prosecutions have been made.
A number of organizations have warned in general about the stability of tailings dams in this region. They fear that not enough maintenance was being done, but also because the impact of the collapse of some of these dams could be very serious. It could, in fact, affect the water supply of Belo Horizonte, which is a city of several million people. This isn't the first time that there has been the collapse of a tailings dam in Brazil. In November 2015, in Mariana, which is also in Minas Gerais, a even larger tailings dam collapsed. And this had about 50 million cubic meters of mining waste in it. And this spread all down the Rio Doce as far as the Atlantic Ocean, which is 600 kilometers away.
Brumadinho, a gente não sabe ainda. A gente ainda não tem a extensão da tragédia. A gente sequer tem a extensão da tragédia em Mariana. A gente está há 3 anos de tragédia.
Both Brumadinho and Mariana were mines which were owned by Vale. Both were iron ore mines. In both cases, the tailings dams had been believed to be stable and had received a certificate from an independent consultant that they were stable, but they still collapsed.